You've made your point, Goldfinger. Thank you for the demonstration.
Oh no, Mr. Bond. The fun has all. The fun has only just begun.
Just remember to talk, Goldfinger.
No, Mr. Bond, I expect you to die. You know nothing.
Oh, really? I'll tell you what I know. I know you've been pussy. Yes. I know your dirty little secrets.
It is not possible, Mr. Bond. She's immune. If you think I'm gonna you, Goldfinger, you got another thing coming. Oh. Someone let the cat out of the bag, Mr. Bond.
You're a monster. Let me out of this thing, right now.
Oh, but I cannot, Mr. Bond. I do not know the controls. It is up to you. You've always got a plan hidden somewhere. Bye.
No, please.
Hello there, Bond fans. So, back today with my third James Bond review, where we shall be reviewing the third Sean Connery James Bond adventure, and by far the best Sean Connery adventure, Goldfinger. Yeah, so, basically, the plot of Goldfinger is that Bond is trying to stop Auric Goldfinger, this man who wants to, this gold smuggler, and his plan is to basically infiltrate Fort Knox to basically steal the gold and exploit it and basically open up his own bank and exploit the gold for tons of money. That's pretty much it, and infiltrating Fort Knox, that's pretty much it. So Sean Connery stars yet again as Bond, and the guy has never been better. This is by far his best performance, and definitely one of the best performances of the entire series. It's that good. Connery really just, he's in his zone. He is settled into the role like nobody's business. He is in there. He is Bond. He is Bond. This is his Bond film. His best Bond film. And Goldfinger is the quintessential Bond film. It is the one that defined the series. Like, the first two, they were good. Like, Dr. No was good. I really liked that. From Rush with Love, that was also good, but it had a few issues. This was when people went, okay. This is when people started to pay attention to James Bond. First two movies, people thought, okay, this is new. But this is like, people were like, wow, with this one. They're like, this series is something else. And I'll tell you something. The cast is so good here. As I said, Connery as Bond is perfect. I think, this is definitely his best performance of all of his six films. I don't count Never Say Never Again because that's not official and I've never seen it. So out of the six Bond films he's done, this is definitely his best. The story is just great. It flows really well. It really fits with Connery's Bond as well. It's quite a serious Bond film. There are a few one-liners in there. But it's a nice balance. It's a good fun time. It's 1 hour 50 minutes long. which is perfect. And the pacing, wow, this movie goes so quickly, which makes a real change from the first movie, the first two films. Doctor No was good, but it had its slow moments. From Rush of Love was a bit slower, and you know, some of the scenes were quite dull. But here, almost every scene keeps you intrigued. Like, I love the scene when they're playing golf. It's such a simple scene, but there's actually quite a lot of intensity behind it. Kind of like the card game in Casino Royale, but I'll talk about that in the Casino Royale review. And, you know, the other great scenes, like the action scenes are really good. The car chase is really awesome. The opening action sequence is really awesome. The storming of Fort Knox is really good. Some of the best action put on screen in the 60s. The action is superb. And the plane fight at the end. Yeah, so we like about Goldfinger's death, but, you know, I thought it was good for the time. The cast, as I said, very good. Gert, Frobe as Goldfinger, he is great. Goldfinger is my favourite James Bond villain, along with Oddjob. I think they're just such a great pair of villains. He's just so sinister. You can tell his frustration with Bond is just like, they're both kind of equal. You know, they're both equals, you know. Bond is one step ahead of Goldfinger, and then the next moment Goldfinger's one step ahead of Bond, and round we go. They bounce off each other really well, and, you know, Connery and Frobe managed to capture that intensity between the two characters really well. That really works, and it makes for a really intriguing story as well. Like, you really feel that the guy is determined to do anything he wants to get that gold, and Bond is determined to do anything to, you know, stay focused on his mission. Pussy galore. Now, I know what you're going to say. It's a kind of a controversial name, and it is a bit bizarre, and it is a kind of a stupid name in a sense, but it's kind of funny, actually. I mean, when you first hear it, you're like, what the hell is this? But, you know, over the time I've watched it, I've actually kind of gone, well, you know, it was the time, it was the 60s, you got to learn to appreciate the stuff, but Seek a Lot, like, exposing a child to this film wouldn't be very good, I would, even just for that character's name. So if you have children, I'd advise you to wait until they're a certain age. That being said, Goldfinger was the first Bond film I ever saw, so I do have a lot of nostalgia for this as well. Honor Blackman's really good in the role, and apparently the character's a lesbian, but, like, I don't know. I think she's more kind of bisexual, to be honest. There's that scene in the Bond when Bond is he's trying to sort of win her over, and she kind of falls for his charm. If anyone was a lesbian, I don't think they'd be turned that quickly. I think she's probably bisexual. But yeah, no, we'll never know. Shirley Eaton appears as Jill Masterton for a brief 5 minutes on screen. Some of the, you know, the most memorable cinematic moments of Bond, like when she's painted in gold and on the bed, that's really cool. And of course, the scene when Bond is strapped up to the laser, the table, and the laser is going about to hit his genitals. And he's like, "Do you expect me to talk?" He's like, "Just for me to talk, Goldfinger." He's like, "No, Mr. Bond, I expect you to die." Like, it's a really classic scene, and the two actors are great. It's so intense. Change of directors as well. Terence Young directed the first two films. He did a pretty good job, I guess. This movie's directed by Guy Hamilton. And he's like, okay, let's vamp this up a bit, you know. There's much more of an excitement in this film. There's much more of an exciting vibe. From Rush of Love, kind of few dull moments, but it was a good film, but it was just dull. Doctor No, they had to establish, so I kind of let them off for that, but this movie, it's so exciting. Like, you look forward to all these scenes that happen. It takes itself pretty seriously. Tilly Masterton is good as well, though she doesn't really do much. The way she dies is kind of silly. I mean, as if that would really happen, you know. The hat. Oddjob. Oddjob is the best henchman ever. The fact that he doesn't say anything makes him all the more better. He is just classic. I love, you know, the way he sort of, he just like approaches Bond. He's like, just like this big hench guy. Bond like throws the gold brick on him and he literally just comes off him like that. And the fight between Bond and Oddjob in the end is fantastic. Brilliant, 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 brilliantly directed. So yeah, Guy Hamilton is a great director. Probably the best Bond director. Who knows? Goldfinger is really good. There's a nice plot that it has, you know, the characters are great, the storyline's great. Cinematography is superb. Geneva, Switzerland, beautiful. The views are just beautiful. And this movie, more than the first two, shows Connery's Bond in sort of a more vulnerable situations. Like the first two films, he was in those situations, but he was always able to get them out easily. With this, you're like, he doesn't know what to do at some points. He's like, how do I get out of this? He struggles. Like when he's strapped up to show, he's like, you can tell that he's actually kind of desperate to get out. He's kind of, you know, playing on the edge, you know. Of his life. He's like, can you afford to take that chance? You know, you can tell he's really, how can I put it? He's on edge. He's about to die. He's like, ooh. But, yeah, and I think there are times he doesn't look like he can face Oddjob, and, you know, and when he gets put in the prison cell, when he's, like, winking at the guy, he's like, that was really funny. I love that scene. The climax is awesome at Fort Knox. It's just a brilliant work of cinema. There's not much more to say. Yeah, there are moments which are kind of sexist, like when Connery slaps the woman's ass. It's it does take on a bit of a sexist vibe, you know, sexist tones, but it was the 60s, so times have moved on since then. So as long as people just respect that it was in the 60s and it's not any, you know, now, then, you know, I can understand. I mean, I myself don't agree with it, but you have to appreciate that it was the time. Yeah, I think this is among one of the best Bond scripts ever. And, you know, they just, all the actors, you know, portray it so well on screen. It really is the quintessential Bond film brought to life. Well, it's definitely the quintessential Connery film. So, yeah. And the first sort of big Q branch scene, I mean, well, we had a Q scene in the From Russia With Love, but we haven't had, like, the proper Q branch scene until now. This is awesome. Like, the DB5 is great with the ejector seat and everything, and the gadgets are cool. Like, this was really good for the time. People were like, okay, wow, you know, they're actually giving this a bit of a revamp up, because in From Russia With Love it was just one scene. So, you know, Desmond Llewellyn is great, but in From Russia With Love that scene, it was just the briefcase. So, yeah. But nevertheless, I think Goldfinger's a really, really good film, and I love it. Pacing is perfect. It's 1 hour 50 minutes long, which is perfect. 5 minutes shorter than From Russia With Love, although From Russia With Love feels a lot longer. Kind of like the fact that we're kind of just restricted to two villains this time, whereas in the first film it was just Dr. No, but he barely appeared. Well, and the three blind mice as well, the assassins. Three blind mice in a row. From Russia With Love, you have Spectre. Which I believe return in the next one, Thunderball. I believe they return in Thunderball, but I can't remember. I haven't watched that film for ages. And Goldfinger, we just have Goldfinger and Oddjob, which is fine by me. I think they're really good, you know. Cinematography is perfect. It's brilliantly shot. It's beautifully paced. It's a fantastic thriller. And this is definitely Sean Connery's best Bond film, which is why I believe it deserves a 10 out of 10.
Goldfinger, he's the man with the Midas touch.
Masterpiece. An absolute masterpiece. Yeah. I mean, if they wanted to go one better, they could have introduced a bit of an emotional chord in there, because there's not really an emotional kind of thing in there. Well, I mean, like the death of the other sister, the death of Tilly, sort of, from Bond's perspective, it's like, oh, like it's a little bit emotional, but they could have kind of ramped up the emotion. That's really the only criticism I have, ramp up the emotion, because there's not really much emotion in there, but it's still a fantastic film. That's a minor gripe. This is a brilliant film, one of the best in the series. And it's a shame that it follows with one of the worst films of the series, and it's my least favourite. So with that in mind, next time I'm going to be reviewing Thunderball, the fourth Connery adventure. Yes. So anyway, thank you all for watching. As always, I'm Mr. Tardis 11.
See ya.